eyes. Oh no. Oh wait. What's that? Right there.
Thank you.
Look what he put on the back of it.
I'm not sure. What do you say? What do you say? You know what you're saying? You're talking to me. What do you say?
Talking to you.
Talking to you. Sticky, right? Even a day later, it's still sticking to your fingers and everything you touch. How about that? Careful with it, because you get it on something, it's sticky for a week. It's like, I don't know what they put in it. So it must be like a pine gum or something. It's not like a white glue. It's a white glue, but it's got some other additive that it just wants to stick forever. He's very special to me. Yeah, you know he is, don't you? You know I like him, don't you? Yeah. A lot, that's right. You're just jealous. Don't hurt me. You're just jealous. Yeah, I talked to my cat. I'm trying to figure out his emotional language. You know, they're a very emotional creature, right? And you be around a cat long enough, you start to connect with it emotionally, with the way they speak to you. Like, they, I swear they have their own language, right? Because they got so many different meows. It's like, wow. That's stuck to my fingers. And I'm going to use that white glue again that I just put away. Like, even I notice my cat, he'll get very, he'll get very annoyed with me, and he'll give a different meow after meowing the same for like 5 minutes, right? And then I'll notice he'll turn and he'll walk away, and he'll meow in a totally different way. It's like he's fed up. It's like, whatever, right? And he walks away, and you know he's fed up. That his tone changes completely from happy to this really disgruntled. He's angry, right? He's disgruntled when he's walking away, right? And I realized that, I caught that one day. I noticed, like, oh my god, he's got attitude. Yeah, don't you? He's not very talkative. He just ate, so he's not very talkative. So yeah, I noticed his emotional. They speak with emotion. They're operating from a completely emotional place, right? So, how do you understand their language? Emotionally. It's not that complicated, right? There's so many creatures that have a part of their brain responsible for emotion. Do you know the whales have a larger part of their brain responsible for emotion than we do? And you know what? That makes a lot of sense. Look how calm they are, right? They're a much more evolved creature than us. The whales, you know, do you ever see them? They sleep upside right, in upside down in the sea. They float up and down just under the surface of the water. And you'll see them all in a row when they do that. And it's just like, it's so remarkable, right? Can you imagine being one of those lucky divers in life who have that chance in life to go swim alongside them while they're sleeping? I think there's a video on YouTube that have that. Check it out. And I think that, like, when they captured that baby whale and they took it away from its parents, did you know those family whales were crying for days when they abducted that baby whale, a member of their family? They witnessed it being taken. It's a wonder they didn't get eaten to death, right? And witnesses, I think you've all seen the black, what is it, the black, if I forget the name, black whale, no, something black, the killer whale, orcas. Black orca, maybe. What do you think? Sammy. And it really bothered the witnesses that I'm just gonna do this. Alright. I love to do this, you know that, right? And it's still 11:23 from a distance it looks like pubic hair, right? That's intentional, by the way. That's just my head. Sexual. He's so gorgeous. I love him so much. So yeah, look at his eyes, you know, right? Look at that eternal spirit of Sammy. I just hope you survive, baby.
Don't take any shit from anybody. They give you shit, you throw it back in their face twice as hard, and you walk away, and you never talk to them again. You never allow yourself to trust anyone who's betrayed you or in any way. Because that's a trauma wound of behavior, right? People who are judgmental and critical of you, right? So unless they heal those wounds, you can expect them to always be like that for the rest of their life if they never get any help, right? So that's why I don't bother with people once they do that. I never had anything to do with people after in life. Not a qualm about leaving them behind me, right? My dust bitches. Oh, I love you so much, Sammy. God. Oh. I love him forever. And you know what? This... They're going to be talking about this piece forever. This, just leave it to your imagination, right? And ball sack and the penises, right? That's why he's doing this, right? It's an eroticism. And this could be the clitoris too, right? The vagina, the dildo. Yeah! Huh! And of course, Sammy's going to be someone that you'd be highly protected, right? The gold taps. You can count on that. Nobody's ever going to hurt Sammy. God help him if anyone does. I'll come after them myself. So, yeah. I'm going to double sign this. I'm just going to call the piece how I feel, right? I love you forever. Sad. Extra Y. It represents my trans name too a bit. So yeah. It's double sign. We'll say if it's double sign, it means you're nothing, but this is an original. So bye. Donate this to the museum and then we'll admit me, right? In person, right? So some of these little details I forgot, right? There's actually a little sad face in here. You know, in life, I was saying to somebody today that there's no such thing as a perfect happy life. Nobody lives a perfect happy life, you know? We all go through our emotional shit storm. You wouldn't be human if you didn't, right? So that one's, he's upset because he's laying sideways, right? He's like, oh, whatever. And this one, this one's happy. He looks like he's high. Yeah. Humor me. Humor me. And this one, he's like, he's got his mouth wide open. And that's it. So with this, you have mostly white. All, a lot of black, and then a bit of medium light. Medium composition light is the least amount of light. And
Although this would be medium too, right? It's almost balanced out with the black. Maybe I'll go a little more black down there and make that medium pop. That would balance. Well, that'd be too heavy down there. Maybe. No, actually, this would be, this should be black. Because it's black. Black. Yeah, I gotta add some more black.
So,
the least amount you university students, you all know this, right? Okay, that's a mistake.
I need pure stuff here.
I need to get the water content is too high, so we're gonna go a little more pure.
Ink.
Way too much ink there, but I wasted that.
So mostly white.
Look at that. This isn't the actual folder. It's kind of a nice weird layer. A little bit of medium there. I'm just going to come across here. The black. And that's going to balance out your black there. Too much medium light, so I want to tone down the medium light. I want to highlight something, just leave a little bit. Kind of screwed up that part, didn't I? That black. I'm just gonna leave that. I'm gonna draw straight lines. Slow down. Just slow down. So now you have balance on the black, right? This is kind of a lot of black there, so it's almost the same, right? Here you've got black, black, and black. A little bit of medium light. A little bit of medium light. This would be more black than medium light, right? So what happens is the brain sees the least amount of light. I don't know, we don't know why, scientists don't know why. Whatever the least amount of composition light, whether it's black composition, white, a lot of white composition, whatever the least amount, in this case, it's, I love using the medium as the least amount. I try to, when I do my compositions, I keep that in mind when I'm, you know, taking the photo over and cropping it in a way that gives me that, right, balanced blacks, balanced whites, balanced mediums, focal point becomes the medium lights, right? So yeah, even your lines, see, it's all pointing to the medium, see what that is? And then your golden rule, the one is in the 1/3 box right here. That's your focal point. It's this point's up to here. It's got the golden ratio, which is 1/3 and 1/3, almost. It should actually be up here, but as long as it's in that reach, anyway, the eye is going to go to that. So your eye is here on the medium light, And then you can, it's pulled down here. I think the eye goes to them. You got to be. And you're looking at it. You like what I was. You were listening to me. You liked what I was saying, right? Yeah. Continue, right? So. Kind of distracting, so I'm just going to come in here, more medium light. It was kind of glaring. I didn't like that. This should all just be. It dries very quickly, so be careful with ink. Yeah, you could scrub it out, but you might end up doing damage. And it's a lot of waste of energy when you do that too, right? So just scoop it up. There we go. Done. Red hearts. I'm very connected with him in my heart, right? I won't always be around to protect him, so I hope this always reminds him of me. Sammy, I love you forever. With you after I'm gone. I'll be right here. What you do with me. I'll know how you feel about everything, every moment. I'll know when you're feeling down. Whatever idiot chooses to make you feel that way. I'm gonna know. Bitches. I'm gonna live forever. Y'all better just leave Sammy alone.
God help you if you don't. God won't help you.
Yeah, anyone hurt Sammy. God helps those who love God. That's how God chooses you. It's not God choosing you. It's you choosing God. Think about that. When you choose compassion, right? What is that? It's godly. When you turn towards compassion, you're turning towards the godliness of yourselves. Loving. You're born from love. Intense love, I might add. Yeah? Like heaven on earth kind of loving sex, right? Like, there's your answer. If you're anything other than that, you're not of God. You're of some stupid, egotistic nightmarish oppression.
Often self-oppression. But we all go through those stages in life where
we're negative thinking. And, you know, maybe we came through some really bad relationships. Right? And we don't feel this connectedness. Right? This is very sexual for me. So, when we don't have connectedness, tend to scream about it,
You have tantrums, right? So you see yourself in conflict. It's because you're not feeling a connectedness. What you're really saying is, I don't feel connected. Somebody hold me, right? Every parent knows that about a kid, right? They have tantrums. It's because they haven't been held, or they're tired, and they need somebody to hug or hold them, right? You know? Look how graceful we are with the child, right? Yeah, so if you're not graceful with them as adults, they're not gonna like that. Ever. So why be that way? No one wants that. Stop criticizing each other. Stop being judgmental. God's watching us all. Love you forever, Sammy.